In this video, I will show you how to back up and restore communication books via iTunes, a new feature in GoTalk NOW version 4.0. This process will be largely identical for Mac and Windows users, with one minor difference that will be covered later on in the video. Let's begin. Here I have iTunes open, and the iPad is connected to the computer via USB cable. We will start by clicking on the iPad button up here in the corner. And then over to the Apps heading near the top center of the window. This will show us all of the apps installed on the iPad, and if we scroll down, we can see the file sharing section. And as we can see, GoTalk NOW is now an option. Listed to the right are GoTalk NOW documents, which are the communication books saved in GoTalk NOW. To back up a book, we simply have to click, drag, and drop the folder on the desktop. Alternatively, we can click the Save To button down in the corner, which opens a Save dialog box, allowing us to save the backup wherever we please. And now I will show you how to restore the communication books that have been backed up. This is where the process slightly differs for Mac and Windows users, and we'll start with Mac. iTunes is open to the file sharing section as I demonstrated earlier. Now the first thing we have to do is compress our backed up communication book. This is accomplished simply by right-clicking on the folder of our backed up book and selecting Compress. This will create a zipped version of our communication book. Now all we have to do is drag and drop the zipped file to the GoTalk NOW Documents section. Alternatively, clicking the Add button brings up the Open Dialog box, allowing us to select the zipped backup from wherever we have it saved. Just be sure to select the zipped file and not the uncompressed folder. Now I will cover restoring communication books for Windows users. iTunes is open, and the iPad is connected via USB cable. We will navigate to the file sharing section in the same manner by clicking on the iPad button, then the Apps heading, and then scrolling down to the bottom of the page. Now we have to compress our backup. To do this, we right-click on the folder of our backed-up book, select Send To, and then Compressed Zipped Folder. And again, all we have to do is drag and drop the zipped folder in the GoTalk NOW Documents section. This can also be accomplished by clicking the Add button and using the Open Dialog box to navigate to where the backup is stored. Again, being sure to select the zipped file and not the uncompressed folder. And now for the final step, and it's an easy one at that. All we have to do is open GoTalk NOW, and it will automatically recognize the backup. Scanning for backups only occurs when the program is launched, so if it does not recognize the backup right away, just close the program and then reopen it. Once recognized, it will then ask us what we want to call the communication book. We will notice that the title is already filled in, and if we don't want to alter it, all we do is tap the Create button, and voila, we now have restored our backed up communication book.